let you know what time it is right here, right now. It's time for hashtag Too Many Hashtags, where we tell you guys all things current as well as all things trending through the use of hashtags.
You know, on social media, when you make a post or status, we tend to go in.
Go in.
On the hashtags. This segment is called hashtag Too Many Hashtags, where we give you guys all things trending, all things current through the use of hashtags. Hashtag a Netflix fix. Now, attention all couples and friend groups, this hashtag is for you, okay? Don't you hate when you start a Netflix series together and vow not to watch ahead, but then somebody ends up breaking the promise and now you've got trust issues? Yeah, me too. Listen, y'all, Netflix says that they have a solution to this Netflix sitch as they introduce a binge co-watching contract, creating a civil agreement before anyone watches a new series on Netflix. The contract is an actual document that requires signatures before granting access to watch absolutely anything. Now, Mia, do you think that this document that Netflix is creating will solve the problems, or are we going to just face the same
issues? So we're talking about a physical document that your friends, your boyfriend or girlfriend are going to have to sign in order to... Come on now. Is that really necessary?
I mean, well, why not, Mia? I've heard relationships are breaking up because you broke the promise of watching something before you were supposed to be watching.
Okay, now listen. I'm going to say that, okay, maybe this is the reason why I'm not really necessarily tripping on this. I have been guilty of watching a show when I was originally watching it with someone, i.e. Misa. And I've moved forward. I mean, my thing is like, I've moved on in watching the show, but that doesn't mean I don't mind watching it again.
Okay,
you know what I'm saying?
But the thing is, man, you don't understand. Like, it's all about real time. You know, like the real reactions, the real response to what happened in the plot and the whole series and situations. Like, it's all about that. I wanna be able to experience it with you firsthand.
It's okay. I can fake all of my reactions as if I've never seen it before.
Yeah.
I've done it before. It's acting 101.
Yeah, and every time you did it, I knew that you watched it before I did.
Dang.
Yeah. Oh, busted. Well,
dang.
Busted and disgusted.
Pass me the contract. Someone hand me a pen. I guess.
The thing is I can see where they're coming from. And I mean, to a lot of people, it may seem like Netflix is doing something silly, but I think it's a good solution. Because I mean, a lot of people actually take this to heart.
Maybe they're saving relationships out here.
Maybe
that's really what's going on.
Kudos
to Netflix for, you know, building this contract to save relationships all over the world.
I truly agree, because it's a sin if you do it in a relationship.
Oh, God.
Hashtag in this day and time.
Hashtag they can lie and cheat.
Hashtag but one thing that's off the table.
Hashtag is watching Netflix without me.
Hashtag too many hashtags.
Listen to this one, guys. Hashtag a mom pressured procedure. Carla Bellucci, a mother and former glamour model, wants her 14-year-old daughter, Tanisha, to get plastic surgery like her. Carla told Closer Magazine, she will need to rely on her looks to get on in life, so she will need to be perfect. Ugly people get nowhere these days. She went on to say, at the moment, she loves the Kardashian look with the big bum and boobs and pouty lips. She's going to get fillers when she's 16, which I fully support. Carla. Listen,
16.
Carla, 16. The girl is 14 right now. And honestly, I don't know about you, but listen, okay, one thing, let's talk about plastic surgery for a minute, just in general. I feel like, listen, bro, do whatever you want with your money, okay? You know what I'm saying? Personally, I wouldn't do plastic surgery because there's nothing that about my features or my body or anything that I think that is that deep to where I want to take it to the doctor to fix.
Right.
If you want to do that, that's fine. That's on you. However, I would not push that to my 14-year-old daughter or to 14-year-olds in general, because, I mean, you're still growing. Like, you know what I'm saying? I do not look the same as I did when I was 14. You're going to grow. You're going to evolve. You're going to mature. You know what I'm saying? So it's kind of like, don't tell your 14-year-old daughter to get surgery that she needs to rely on her looks, as if her looks will be the only thing to get her far in life. Not her hard work, not her stamina, not her personality, not characteristics, but solely her looks. There's something wrong with that.
I think I've come to the conclusion that we live in a very sad and cold world. The things that I'm seeing that comes across our social media and, you know, come across the news is really just mind-blowing.
Yeah.
But, you know, the thing is, it's like, you totally are 110% correct when it comes to talking about this young girl, but there are even women that are so much older than her, including the Kardashians, that feel like they need to opt in enhancing their body surgically than just doing it the natural way. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I get it, the fact that you can go ahead and use your money, do whatever you want, but we still, as women, have such a long way to go when it comes to self-confidence.
I just feel like there's a different thing about pushing that into a young girl, because, like, you're trying to figure yourself out. She's only 14, bro. So, you know, there are so many other things in life you need to be worrying about, like your math tests. You're trying to make the cheerleading squad, not the way your lips look in your Instagram photos.
Yeah.
There are bigger fish to fry when you're 14.
I feel like at that point, you need to push away from social media for a while and push away from television for a little while.
Or something along those lines.
Yeah.
Hashtag at age 14.
Hashtag you should be carefree and having fun.
Hashtag not stressing about having.
Hashtag big lips and big buns.
Hashtag too many hashtags. Listen, guys, we're giving you hashtag too many hashtags. That's right. All things current as well as all things trending through the use of hashtags.
Hashtag Little Mermaid, big noise. So folks are already mad that one of Beyonce's proteges, Halle Bailey, was casted to be Ariel in Disney's new live-action Little Mermaid movie. Well, people can add to their haterade collection because Queen Latifah has been casted to play Ursula, and reggae singer Shaggy has been casted to play Sebastian the Crab. And just to clarify, y'all, please listen carefully. Queen Latifah and Shaggy were casted in the live television version of The Little Mermaid live and not the live action Little Mermaid movie remake. So just kind of like, just to clarify, Ursula being played by Queen Latifah and Shaggy playing Sebastian the Crab will not be seen with Halle Bailey. They're two different things. Little Mermaid Live is different from the Little Mermaid live action movie.
Whose idea was this?
Yeah, a lot of people got in their feelings because they were thinking
I thought she was going to be in the live action movie. I was going, that's going to be so dope.
It would have been the icing on the cake, but, you know, we have to just kind of wait to see whoever they cast as actually Ursula and Shaggy, or Sebastian, I should say, and also King Triton.
Now, I do think that is still a great pick. Queen Latifah. Oh, man, I wish she would have been live action movie.
It would have been dope.
That would have been so dope. But yeah. I still think that she's going to do great. I think Disney should consider her also for, you know, the live action movie. I think they'll be great. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, hopefully we can see. We'll treat the live action movie as, like, you know, a teaser, you know, like an audition. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We'll see. I really think that she should do the live action movie. But side note, who do you think should play Sebastian in the live action movie?
I think Shaggy should.
Listen, is it weird? Okay, is it weird if I say I want for Mr. Mosby from 12 Second Cody to be him? Can't you see that? Like, is that weird? Because I really thought that would be like the perfect fit.
That doesn't sound too bad.
You know what I'm saying? But he kind of has that.
But the thing is, I want the real Caribbean island vibe.
Okay.
You know,
okay,
I want the dialect. I want the whole nine yards when it comes to this live action.
Because honestly, listen, if there's any Disney movie that I'm live action, live, whatever it may be, that I'm really have high standards for,
gotta be right.
It's this one. Because listen, I had the DVD, I had the VHS. I know the Little Mermaid like the back of my hand. So listen, I have high standards. So forget the rest of the world. Don't let me down.
Yeah, Mia is definitely Halle Bailey's understudy.
Yes, all day. Warm up my voice.
Hashtag it's above water.
Hashtag or under the sea.
Hashtag I will be watching.
Hashtag to support both Queen and Halle.
Hashtag too many hashtags.
Here's the last one for you guys. Speaking of Beyonce, hashtag DC3 in 2020. Listen to this one, y'all. Beyonce has been secretly planning a huge reunion tour for Destiny's Child for 2020 to celebrate 20 years of being one of the biggest girl groups of all time. Now, sources say that Beyonce saw the success of the Spice Girls tour and she wants to replicate that, but bigger and better. And Kelly and Michelle are on board. Now, how do you feel about this? Do you think this will actually, like, fully follow through? Because I've heard rumors of this before.
I think this is amazing. Yes, most definitely. Beyonce and her team are genius.
Now, I feel like because Beyonce's putting it together, it's for sure gonna happen. But honestly, to be completely 100% with you, I never really thought Beyonce would ever even want to do anything like this, to be honest with you. Not saying that she's, like, a bad person. I'm not saying that at all. I just never thought that she would even want to, like, revisit that time in her life. Not that nothing about it was bad or anything, but I just never thought that she would even want to do something like this.
Look, ever since her homecoming performance at Coachella, also known as Beachella, and DC3 came up, the crowd went insane, and I felt their energy through the TV.
Listen, I guess Misa's gonna get her tickets, man.
Oh, yeah.
So Misa will definitely be there. Hashtag, can you keep up?
Hashtag with Michelle, Kelly, and B.
Hashtag, the best of all time.
Hashtag, say their name.
DC3.
Hashtag too many hashtags. There you go, guys. That was hashtag too many hashtags. Listen, tune in next week as we give you guys more current topics, some more things that are going on in today's world.
Y'all, it's getting a little bit hotter as we spin nothing but hot tracks off the racks.
Ooh, sizzling.
Sizzling right here on Eminem Live Radio. But also, we've got a great conversation all centered around this right here. Is it always necessary to cut people off in order to grow?